What's up, everybody? It's live reaction time. Gauntlet for the Gold, Impact on Pop, GFW, Gauntlet for the Gold, 20 men, 20 guys in it, 20 wrestlers from different companies and from GFW. Thought I'd do a live reaction. We're 10, 11 guys in. Couple have been thrown out. Here comes number 12. Phantasma. That's the guy's name. He's from AAA promotion. Never heard of that.
To be considered a favorite to win for a number.
Mask on, he's pretty built.
In fact, he can go toe to toe with just about anybody in the ring, including EC3. Phantasma.
Shining
in this corner for the gold. Who will be the new world champion? Who's going to be the surprise grand prize? We're going to find out.
Keep track of all the guys that came in.
I'm sleeping.
Stupid commercials now, but number 12's from AAA. Phantasma, whatever the guy's name is. So I'll give you the rundown. Who started off the gauntlet for the gold? Number one. Number one was Eddie Edwards. Number two was Eli Drake. Number three was Baraka. Something Baraka, the guy's name is. Number four was Eddie Kingston. He's returned. I think he's part of the Beatdown Clan before an Impact. Number five was Braxton Sutter. Number six was Richard Justice. A fat guy. Looked like WCW's Roadblock. Like Roadblock had a kid. But Richard Justice, number six, the guy really looked like, to me, a really, really fat Ron Jeremy. The porn star. Number seven was EC3. Number eight was Congo Kong. Number nine was Suicide. Number ten was Mahabi Sheeran. Number 11 was Chris Adonis. And number 12 was from AAA promotion. Phantasma, whatever the guy's name is. So when the Impact comes back, every 2 minutes they have an entrant. When Impact on Pop comes back, hopefully they have number 13 come out. But these commercials are way over 2 minutes. I'm just writing all the names down that are in the gauntlet for the gold because I'm doing a review after this live reaction for Impact on Pop. These stupid, boring commercials.
But clears the yellow line. Diaz has had a good night as he fouls one off. You know, I mentioned earlier the Indians
turn
are not
the
in position.
Turn the MLB Network because I hate watching commercials.
Able to do, but what they were able to do is very sneaky under the radar and getting Jay Bruce.
Diaz with a shot to right. Mookie Betts trying to run it down, but he can't. Crashes into the wall. Diaz sprinting for third, and he will make it.
Triple right there by the Indians. They get a triple.
Diaz, who entered the game.
It's Indians Red Sox, by the way, if anybody cares.
Walked double.
Goodness. Natural cheese.
Impact still not.
Yeah, he's got it.
Still on commercials. Like 4 minutes of commercials.
God is pretty impressive. Come get the walk and then the cycle. His ability so far to go to right field seems comfortable. I've seen this kid a long time as he's trying to find a...
Still on damn commercials.
Roberto Perez to the plate. Taking...
So my guess is the gauntlet for the gold is going to go the rest of this Impact on Pop episode with like 30 minutes left. Number 13 is supposed to come in. So the match is going to run an entire full hour of Impact on Pop. And that's a good thing. I always enjoyed a lot the Gauntlet for the Gold matches. I always thought they were very entertaining. They're like the Royal Rumble almost, but only 20 guys.
Wow. You're real.
Still on damn commercials.
Blaine Boyer, who was up earlier, throwing again.
Something, but it takes a knee.
So I don't know if this preseason game is happening right on Thursday right now, but it's Dolphins and Eagles, 31-31. Think right before halftime.
Game. We're way over 600 yards of offense. Wow.
The third quarter. Over 600 yards of offense. That's pretty crazy.
Great.
For a preseason game. That means no defense is being played at all.
It was indeed a sixth-round pick a couple of years
back
ago.
Impact. It should be back.
In.
Johnny Impact. Johnny Mundo. He's Johnny Impact now. He's in.
I'll be looking at the next global champion.
Pop. I expect him to win it. But I think I know he's going to win because I heard a spoiler. I heard the spoiler by accident, who I think wins it. And I don't think it's Johnny Impact.
Championship gold everywhere he's gone, including AAA, where he's the current.
Johnny Impact just clotheslined Chris Adonis over the top. He's eliminated.
Johnny Impact.
This
suicide.
Is a game changer indeed.
Johnny Impact
here, a huge surprise. Nobody was
planning
for Johnny Impact in this match.
John Morrison, Johnny Impact.
Certainly as we've seen before. Boy, if you follow this man's career. Wow. Takes out Suicide and already.
Suicide eliminated.
Eliminated Adonis, took out Suicide. Johnny Impact is in the ring. Who's going to be our 14th entrant?
So Garza
Jr. making his way to the ring, our 14th.
He's a nephew of Hector Garza.
And we do know Loki will be number 20. Johnny Impact.
Garza Jr.
The dropkick from Garza Jr.
We talked about
son. Following
the career of Johnny Impact. I've seen Johnny Impact's career from day one. This dude is legit. I'm telling you right now, with Johnny Impact in this, that being a trending topic, he's got momentum on his side.
Garza Jr. is...
Garza Jr. facing off with Braxton Sutter.
Wow, sends Braxton
Sutter eliminated.
Garza Jr. eliminates Sutter.
Kicked in
Garza
the back
Jr.
of the head.
He has
over
such tremendous upside. Can you imagine if Garza Jr.
Super kick by Garza
tonight
Jr.
is world
to
champion?
Eddie 28 seconds left until the next guy comes in this gauntlet for the gold.
Another elimination
for the Global Championship. GFW Global Championship. Someone should be coming in about under 10 seconds. Number 14. Or no, number 15.
Taste! And we are 6 seconds away. Who will be number 15 in this gauntlet for the gold for the World Heavyweight Championship?
This Yokozuna looking.
You need a forklift. Somebody needs to grab one and then they'll be able to eliminate Falaba.
400 plus pounds
Falaban
to make his way to the ring.
That's how you pronounce it.
Obviously with the size.
Falaban. Guy looks like Yokozuna, but not as fat.
He
has the same wrestling gear as Yokozuna did.
Everyone.
He's destroying everybody, taking everybody out with shoulder blocks.
He is Falaba, a force in this gauntlet for the gold. And a reminder, folks, check it out one night Friday, September 15th. This is part two of four. You don't want to miss it. Great feedback from all our fans.
It's on been
part
a long
one.
Time
part two, just as good, if not better, and it's coming your way.
Impact on
September 15th.
Yes.
Contact your pay-per-view provider.
Oh, Johnny, Impact is strong, but it's going to take everyone in this ring to eliminate Falabella.
Yokozuna look like.
They got the right idea.
They certainly do.
Pick them up in the corner. Five
this
guys
is the opportunity they have, and EC3 saying, hey, you guys do it.
Smart move by EC3.
EC3 goes on the corner, bottom
wasting his energy. Eli Drake took the same approach as EC3. 25
Eli Drake also left.
For Eddie Edwards and Eli Drake.
K.M.
Entrance 16. K.M. Another big man. Certainly a game changer. So far, with 16 men entered.
So K.M. to me.
We've got 17, 18,
like
19,
young,
and we know 20 is low key.
Or that other guy, Luther Reigns. That guy looks like K.M. also.
The six-sided ring for the first time here on Impact. Well, there's a welcome wagon for him.
Paul Buchanan.
He's got size on his side as well, and strength
Luther
and attitude.
Reigns are no longer
KM,
wrestling.
He can do some damage, but you have the likes
and
of
Eddie Edwards
still in there, and Eli Drake and Johnny Impact, and EC3.
Different job out of wrestling.
This is anyone's to win.
EC3 throws John Morrison on the apron.
Johnny Impact.
Johnny Impact. I get that's a stupid name, but that's his name. I'll call him John Morrison.
Jim Cornette for getting Johnny Impact here now. These two have been locking up
EC3
a lot in this match. Impact.
John Morrison on the apron fight.
Two world-class athletes, and certainly if this is any indication about the heavyweight championship and the future of it.
I would like EC3 to win the title. I think he deserves it.
Taiji Ishimori!
Taiji Ishimori. I think pro wrestling Noah in Japan.
Last week he came up a little bit short against Desmond Xavier. Imagine rebound.
He's short. He's a short guy. He looks like 5'6". 5'5".
Taking the global championship back to Japan would be considered a huge coup for Ishimori. Believe me, he's capable of
Ishimori,
doing it. Crazier things have happened. Certainly all the players involved here. You've got wrestlers from four different organizations in there right now, all competing. And certainly this global championship spans the globe in the truest sense of the word.
And Ishimori's fresh. He's the freshest man in this match right now. He can choose what he wants to do if he can get out of the grasp of KM.
A lot of different talent from four different companies. A lot of international talent in this. Gauntlet for the Gold. I like that. That's cool.
And Eddie Edwards, the two men that started this matchup, are still in.
In the mix of international talent, they got the GFW, some of the roster in there. They don't have that many guys, but they have a few. They're still good stars, like EC3, Moose, Eli Drake, Eddie Edwards, but I think he's done. After these tapings, I think he's leaving.
Bobby Lashley!
There's another GFW roster guy, Bobby Lashley, number 17.
When the final move of Bruce Pritchard was to...
So Lashley will probably be final three or two.
Resolved by reverting to the former champion. Jim Cornette had something to say about that, and since then, Lashley has been in a terrible mood.
So Lashley 17.
And of course,
gone.
What happened at the very end of Impact last week?
Yokozuna is gone.
Lashley, who eliminates Falabella. With
Falabella.
Yeah, and he did it right in front of American Falabella. Team here again to support Lashley. Colby Covington's got to watch himself and keep his hands off of our officials, but these guys are
like
guests.
They are guests, and we're happy to have Dan Lambert here. He apologized to Impact staff for what happened
That's
last week.
Botch.
And there goes Ishimori.
Ishimori
to go back in, and Lashley took care of that.
Ishimori tried to springboard. He botched it and got punched in the jaw by Lashley and falls out of the ring.
Cooler heads will
Ishimori gone.
Happy to have him here as our guest, along with
Ishimori. He's gone.
remember to tell his boys to keep their hands off of the officials. And Lashley, I mean, the timing could have been
who's
better.
Left? EC3, Eli Drake, Eddie Edwards, Johnny Impact, Bobby Lashley. Who else? Garza Jr. is still in there. And one of the mask wrestlers from AAA comes.
There's a big boy coming down. Moose.
Wait for it.
A man who is a former Impact Grand Champion. And I can't think of a man who would be happier to become world champion tonight than this man, Moose.
6'6", under 299 now. He looks
I know, number 20 is.
And Moose.
Number 20 is
yes,
low.
Yes, a favorite, a fresh Moose is dangerous.
Moose,
and
number
luck to Phantasma.
18.
And Moose is so dangerous in the ring and can do things no man his size can do.
He's had a rivalry with EC3. He'll look to eliminate Ethan Carter in this one.
Oh, Moose full steam ahead, and now Garza Jr. Hang on.
Garza Jr.
The attention of Moose.
Just ripped off his
what a distraction,
pants.
And what a super kick by Garza Jr.
Moose holding Garza Jr. up.
What power.
Lift him up. Power bomb over the top.
Garza Jr. over the top rope. Who will be the new
Garza Jr.
We will find.
Landed on Yokozuna lookalike and someone else.
I will get
they
it.
Caught him. They caught him on the outside. That was still awesome. Awesome spot. Moose power bombs. Garza Jr. over the top rope. He's eliminated.
My craft has.
Back to their commercials. So I'm going back to NFL Network.
Third down as we start the fourth quarter. It's going to be a first down.
By the way, Dolphins, you think Jay Cutler's gonna be your savior and help you get to the playoffs? No, he's not. He's terrible. Jay Cutler is terrible. Take it from me. I watched him play for years. I watched Jay Cutler play for years in the NFC North against my Packers, and he's god-awful. He also quits on his team. If Cutler throws like two interceptions and you're down by like 15 or 10, he just decides to quit and looks like he doesn't give a damn.
That's Storm Johnson. Pretty good patience. He's about.
The Dolphins might get to 9 wins, but I don't think they'll get more than 10 wins with Cutler as their quarterback. Yeah, he has a cannon for an arm. Who cares? He's still bad quarterback with, I don't think he has much motivation to win because the guy's never been to Super Bowl.
Of Carew, gotta be more physical.
And that's Cutler's fault. He's with the Bears. He didn't do jack shit for them. Except I think gone to the NFC Championship once where they lost to my Packers. Interception thrown by Dolphins backup. Eagles, I don't know who this is, but he's taking it to the house. 10-yard line.
Inside the 10.
Damn. He's down to like the 3-yard line from after that interception by one of the Eagles. I think the guy's name's Cherry.
Agent a year ago, hooked on with the practice squad.
That was a bad
pass.
Played
some special teams this year. Look at him drop underneath, eyeing the quarterback the whole way. They were looking for Jakeem Grant, and then he shows some athletics.
Three Eagles defenders around one receiver, and they threw it bad pass right into the hands of an Eagle.
Over for Andy Daly. Ferrante's been with that program for years and years, and
guys,
they're one of the best programs.
I think it's Cherry.
Put your V's up.
Hey, they won a national.
Don Cherry? The guy's name's Don Cherry? I think Don Cherry's a hockey announcer in Canada. I heard that name before.
For the Dolphins and the Eagles set up now at the Miami 5.
So Eagles are on the 5-yard line. Still 31-31 for anybody that cares. It's preseason, but still entertaining to watch football.
Player running.
And I still enjoy watching football, even though it's preseason. I wonder, I gotta find out when my Packers play their next preseason game. I mean, look it up here. I believe it's Saturday. Saturday night. That's not a good time. Because on Saturday night, I'll be watching McGregor-Mayweather.
Goes behind him, but a flag. Back shoulder throw, and Lafayette Pitts is going to get called for the pick.
So hopefully when Impact is back, we only have no more commercials after they come back.
Vertel. Or just the fade route. Pitts doesn't try to find a football, face guards him. And because of the contact, not just because of the face guarding, but because of...
A bouncing ball that is taken at second by Ramirez, and they'll settle for the force, with Lindor recording the out at second. So Holt to third. Betts becomes the runner at first. You might have heard the crowd getting on Shaw when the first two reached. It may seem cruel, but Dan Otero...
Indians are winning 10-4.
Decisions
Impact's
made.
Back. Loki's in the ring. He's number 20.
And that he looks like right now
who
in this match.
Number 19.
Look at this. First time ever squaring off these two. Johnny Impact and Loki. Oh, very quick.
Johnny Impact is a master of parkour. He uses those skills inside the ring.
Check this out. He has Loki up now. Loki. Oh, wow. Able to catch himself on the second rope and deliver a foot stomp right to the chest of Johnny Impact.
Variation of the Warrior's Way by Loki.
So who's left?
We have all 20 men. Oh, look out. EC3 nearly eliminates Phantasma. All 20 have entered. Now it's just a matter of the eliminations. Who will emerge victorious? GFW Global Champion.
We're guaranteed a new champion tonight. We're also guaranteed that one of these men will be that
champion. Eight guys left.
Phantasma now. Will he take the championship back to Triple A in Mexico?
EC3 might be eliminated here. No.
That question is no. TK3. EC3 in a great move.
Yeah, TK3 to the outside. EC3 knew what was going on, knew where he was, and knows the match.
EC3 eliminates Triple A mask wrestler.
Lashley still in there. Oh, wow. Great neckbreaker out of nowhere by Eli Drake. Moose in there. Eddie Edwards.
So
we've got a number of four world champions.
Global Force Wrestling talent, that's what.
Just got word that over 30 minutes for Eli Drake and
Johnny
Eddie
Impact.
This match.
I don't know if he signed a contract.
Will they finish it?
He's part of GFW.
Moose now. Oh, wow.
GFW.
There goes
EC3 gone.
Wow, EC3's been eliminated. Slipped off the apron.
Has to be a big
EC3
shocker.
Gone.
That means Moose. That means Lashley. Low-key. Johnny Impact. Eddie Edwards in there.
Moose about to powerbomb Low-key.
And Low-key now. I'm in a bad predicament with Moose. And wow, look at that. Just like that. Oh, the turnaround. A triangle sleeper from Low-key on Moose.
Smart move here. Get Moose. Get the big man down. Get him off his feet.
Doesn't quite have it locked in. Still painful nonetheless. Oh, like
Low-key gone.
Eliminates
Low-key. Low-key tossed. He's on Moose's back. And Dragon Sleeper on Moose. Lashley tossed him out from behind. Over the top. Low-key's gone.
5 men remain. Only one can be the new champion.
5 guys left. Edwards. 5 wrestlers left. Another commercial. More commercials. This hopefully is the final commercials. But said Moose, Lashley, Eli Drake, Johnny Impact, Eddie Edwards are the final five left in the gauntlet for the gold to crown a new Global Force Global Champion.
Souvenir, he's a happy guy.
The lady behind him is real happy because she was thanking him
for taking the brunt of it. This route combination. You're going to see the clearing route by Aguilar and then the dig, the deep inside by Marcus Johnson, who just caught the touchdown pass. 6'1", 200 pounds, ran 4'4 at the University of Texas. There is an awful lot of competition at this wide receiver, and the way I look at it is Jeffrey Smith, Aguilar, and Hollins are all going to make the team, and then Treggs, Marcus Johnson, Shelton Gibson, the fifth-round pick who has struggled, are in the conversation for one or two spots. And a lot of it, and the fact that Hollins is such a good special teams player opens up the possibility of a sixth receiver.
Tell you what, that's a lot of decisions you got to make in terms of how you're forming your roster. And go back to what Doug Peterson told us this week. You're running out of time to see reps for guys that you want to see. Deep kickoff, and once again, a knee. This is a pretty good one. So Betts will be running from first. There he goes, and it's fouled back.
No matter what happens, Boston will maintain their lead. The Yankees lost. Closest competitor in the East.
Call today and ask how to get an equipment, programming, or premium channel upgrade.
You know what? We want to...
Another 3-2 pitch, and he struck him out with a high fastball. Ramirez has struck out twice tonight. He's 0-for-4. The Red Sox threaten, but leave 2. And the kid is already getting texts from his buddies watching the game. Hey, was that you? You okay? Still got the ball? Yes and yes.
Alexa?
That's a great look, isn't it?
Carries it well.
Isaac Sayamala. A lot of hair. Joe Walker. Walker's a good football player. They're going to have trouble cutting him, I think.
He's part of the reason why that interception was thrown last time out, because he was right in the face of Brandon Doughty. Third down, they got to get it to the 35. Dowdy's throw right off the fingertips of Storm Johnson. Then the defense holds, forcing a 3-and-out.
It's waiting for Gauntlet for the Gold. Should be back in like 30 seconds. It's back.
Remain. Eddie Edwards, Moose, Johnny Impact, Eli Drake, and lastly, our final five in the Gauntlet for the Gold. One man will emerge victorious and become the new world champion. Who will it be? Ooh. Lashley's just been unstoppable.
You have five all-stars in the ring right now. You have five men that could very easily be world champion.
Because
and who will emerge victorious?
Moose, Lashley, back up.
Look at this, Moose
back
and
up
Lashley.
In each other.
It's one night only. Keanu Reeves is back to back. First with an all-new episode of Swedish Dicks, followed by the pop premiere of John Wick, then three more episodes of Swedish Dicks. It's all Keanu. It's this Wednesday, 8 p.m.
What the hell kind of shows is Pop TV running? A show called Swedish Dicks. What the hell's that?
Title.
Sounds dumb as hell.
Moose comes in. Lashley follows up with a spear that takes out Moose.
Now you got to get him off the canvas and get him out of the ring.
Here comes Johnny Impact from the second rope. Wow, delivers, you heard it. Tips up. And just like that, Eli Drake takes down Johnny Impact.
Did you see that? Where'd that come from?
Big boot by Moose. There goes Eli Drake.
Pop up power by from Moose.
Eli Drake follows up with a big senton. Five men left.
Moose.
When it comes down to the final two, we will have a matchup to determine the winner via pinfall or submission.
Moose, Lashley's gone. Moose drop kicks Lashley over the top.
A drop kick by Moose that sent Lashley flying to the floor.
Final four left.
Right in front of Danny Edwards, American
Moose,
top team.
Eli
These guys have brought nothing
Johnny.
But bad luck to Lashley.
See it, they really have. Then there were four. Eddie Edwards, Moose, Johnny Impact, Eli Drake. Not so fast. Moose now has Eddie Edwards up. Could this be an elimination? Here goes Eddie Edwards.
Here goes Moose.
There goes Moose.
Moose eliminated.
Edwards stays in. Feet did not touch the
Eddie
floor.
Eddie Edwards took him over with the head.
Three men remain. Johnny Impact, Eli Drake, Eddie Edwards. Your final three are coming for the gold. Our main event tonight. Who will emerge world heavyweight champion?
I think I know his name.
Eddie Edwards has been in that spot before. Can he do it again?
And you've got the newcomer, Johnny Impact, newcomer to GFW, and Eli Drake, who was number two.
Could be. Oh, it really is. Anyone should win.
Eli Drake.
And you have to know Eddie Edwards and Eli Drake both feeling a lot of fatigue.
Eli
after
Drake
starting out
is
1-2 respectively in this matchup.
Like 50
I mean, let's not forget, we didn't see Johnny Impact till 13, and there goes Eli Drake.
Eli Drake almost gone. He's on the apron.
Somehow,
going on.
Holds on with the bottom. Johnny Impact. Are you
kidding
me?
Eli Drake's hanging by his
Eli
2 feet, hanging from the bottom rope. He's not gone. Eli Drake has his feet hanging from the bottom rope. He's back on the apron.
With Johnny Impact.
Going
Eli Drake
the
on the outside. Our final three in our main
Eli
event.
Eli Drake still
in. Emerge as the new GFW Global Champion.
Is known as Mr. AI.
Johnny,
he's showing that here against Johnny Impact.
Forearms, punches, kicks.
As these two talk about Eli Drake and Eddie Edwards started off this matchup. Remember the. Oh,
no. Eli Drake first.
Boy, it looked like it was certainly going to happen there.
Oh! Eli Drake is gone. Wait, no, he's not. I'm confused.
Impact is eliminated.
Johnny Impact's gone. Got pulled off the apron.
It's come down to Eli Drake and Eddie Edwards.
Eli Drake is still in because he flew through the second rope. Under the top rope. He's not gone.
Starting down.
Eddie does a dive through the second rope. Take out Eli.
And this matchup now turns to a pinfall or submission scenario, Josh. Either man.
Now it's pinfall or submission rules.
Pinfall or submission.
Regular
referee,
match rules.
Earl Hebner's in the ring right now. It is now a one-on-one match.
Either Eddie
changes,
or Eli Drake's
going to
be the new global champ.
Eddie Edwards now has Eli Drake.
This is pretty
now,
exciting.
Scouts that. Eddie Edwards turns it around and no.
Eli so just kicks
I mean, it was a counter and another counter.
Suplex powerbomb.
You thunderbomb for the championship.
Eli kicks out again.
How have these two done it? How have these two started this matchup, survived 18 other competitors, and are still
Surprise.
Here?
Surprise.
The very end.
They go with Eddie Edwards as one of the final two because I believe he's leaving. A couple months. Jones.
And now Eddie Edwards comes in full steam ahead. Here's a cover. And no, Eli Drake.
Eli
had his feet on the ropes, but leverage still not enough to beat Eddie Edwards. As it's come down to these final two participants. Through it all. EC3 getting eliminated. Lashley eliminated. Moose eliminated.
Sad thing, I know he's going to win because by accident I heard a spoiler.
Eli Drake just jumps up to the...
But it's still exciting to watch. It's still fun to watch. Eli reverses. High cross body. Picks up Eddie. Picks him on his shoulder.
Look out. Eli Drake.
Finisher.
Edwards. Is that it?
Eli Drake. The new global champion.
The new global force wrestling global champion, Eli Drake.
Started
least,
from the very beginning, and
my
now
opinion,
he's here. An incredible showing.
At least Eli Drake will be a better champion that won't mess up and get in trouble outside of wrestling. At least he won't mess up like Alberto did.
Shock the world tonight!
I like Eli Drake. The guy's a great talker. Lashley's going after some... What the fuck? Lashley's MMA team is beating the crap out of Brian Hebner. They tossed him over the guardrail.
And again, Dan Lambert needs to do something about his dad.
Not Brian Hebner, a different ref. They beat the crap out of... Loose Cannon, part of Lashley's MMA teams, I believe he's an MMA fighter. Thing his name's, I don't know who.
There's Scott DeMore. Damn, Lambert,
Scott DeMore was just pushed down by Lashley's MMA team. Now Lashley's entire MMA team has jumped the guardrail and is helping Lashley to the back.
Team just can't
take him to the back. So Scott DeMore, global force wrestling agent, got pushed down.
Eli Drake, the new champion, happy.
Eli Drake in the ring with the global championship, and Chris Adonis has joined him to celebrate.
Those guys can't be invited back here again. Eli Drake, congratulations, wow, from being put in the number one spot, being moved to essentially the equivalent number two. Eli Drake able to survive 19 other competitors and emerge tonight for the first time in his career as the World Heavyweight Champion. Tonight, Eli Drake is victorious in the Gauntlet for the Gold.
So at least, again, Eli Drake, my opinion, the guy's better than Jinder Mahal. He's better than Jinder. Not as boring and can cut better promos. And can talk. Jinder can't talk for shit. He's stupid. His character's stupid. It's like 1980s character. It's pathetic what Jinder Mahal is as a character. And Eli Drake, I'm all for him being Global Force Wrestling Global Champion because Eli Drake is an original Impact Wrestling talent. Not original, but been there like at least 2-3 years. He's been here. Maybe three, four years. So Eli Drake is the new global champion. The new Global Force Wrestling World Heavyweight Champion. Congratulations to him. I don't got a problem with it. Comment under this video and tell me what you think of Eli Drake being and winning the Global Force Championship. This ends this live reaction for the Gauntlet for the Gold. Bye for now, everybody. Watch and check out my Impact on Pop Gauntlet for the Gold review. Bye for now.